Tuberculosis is still one of the top 10 leading causes of death worldwide. The World Health Organization would estimate there was 1.6 million deaths in 2017 alone from tuberculosis, and about 10 million cases of tuberculosis worldwide. So it's a significant major worldwide health burden. One of the big areas within TB, and that's a particular focus now, is the emergence of resistance. So again, in 2017, about 450,000 people developed resistant tuberculosis, which meant that their TB couldn't always be treated with the existing antibiotics that we have. The UN have now set a goal of ending the TB epidemic, but in order to do that, one piece that's really important is developing new treatment strategies. So here at RCSI, one of the therapies that we are interested in looking at and have done significant work on is a derivative vitamin A, a molecule called all-trans retinoic acid, or ATRA. And this molecule has been of interest in tuberculosis research for many years. But one of the huge issues associated with it in terms of developing it as a clinical treatment is packaging it appropriately for use by patients. So here at RCSI, what we've done is used a spray drying technology to create particles loaded with this ATRA molecule. These particles are suitable for inclusion in inhaler devices, like people might be familiar with asthmatic patients using. The advantage is that the particles then are deposited in the patient's lungs, and our studies to date have shown these particles to be delivered very effectively to diminish the tuberculosis bacteria within the lungs and to diminish the damage of the lungs from the tuberculosis. Based on the work we've done to date, we'd be really excited to see through clinical trial if this could improve TB treatment, and if it did, it has the potential to save hundreds of thousands of lives.